Hey, all you cool cats and kittens. It's Carol at Big Cat Rescue, and Catherine is trying to separate tigers. MC is helping her with evening meds. Starving. She had her whole breakfast this morning. She's just so excited about eating meds. And lately, for some reason, Andre and Arthur insist on being close to each other when they get fed, which is weird, but that's what they're demanding. Evening meds and snacks with Catherine and MC. These tigers you're looking at are 22 years old. It's about twice as long as they are designed to live. They usually only live to be 10 or 12 in the wild and at most other facilities. Here they usually live into their late teens and early 20s, and these guys are really pushing it at 22. So they've got arthritis medicine to take and supplements for, I don't know if they're on supplements for their kittens. A lot of the old cats are.
That's okay. You can just put them on the cart. Okay. Thank you for bringing them out. I appreciate it.
No problem.
Hi. You ready? The to-go order. It's the to-go order.
Oh, I wish I could get breakfast in bed.
Beautiful. They're in amazingly good shape for such old tigers. Watching from Walmart. That's funny.
Hey, can we go around your brother?
Instead of through your brother? So much of the world I'd just love to see, but we gotta fix this problem with big cats being bred for life in prison. I feel like that's something we can fix, and you guys are helping us in that by making the call of the wild at bigcatact.com. Once that's fixed, maybe I can go out in the world and have some fun. But I wouldn't enjoy myself going to Africa or India or Mongolia or any of those places.
knowing that these cats are suffering in cages. Amanda is locked in the cage. She's the one right behind MC there. MC in the green shirt. That's Amanda behind her over in the other enclosure. The other part of the enclosure. Catherine dropped a door between her and the boys so that she doesn't keep some of them. Sherry, Annie is doing great. Go back and look at our live feeds from earlier in the day. He got a blood sickle this morning from Bethann.
No. Oh no.
Woo! She was eyeballing you.
Well, I don't know if it was me or you with that bucket.
Hey, handsome boy.
They are not feeling it. They had already tried to feed Cameron to no avail. I don't know what the roaring was about. Catherine says she's going to try another whole turkey. A couple days ago, they gave him a whole turkey and he ate all the scraps of it. So if that's what he wants, that's what he's going to get. Thanks a lot.
It was kind of interesting, but I don't really deal with any of it. So it was like when you're on hold, when you call the gift shop or something,
It'll
do like a voiceover of your mission and like different ways to help, like instead of music. So I don't know how our phone systems work at all. So I don't know if that's an option we could just do ourselves.
To somebody else.
So,
what's in the box?
Spider getter.
Mm-hmm.
It's a 20 foot long brush to get spiders out of my screen porch.
I sent you the article for the Wildcat Times.
Looks like Cameron's probably gonna eat something.
Oh, wonderful. And Jamie's like, get the camera out of my face, go look at the lion.
See? We do
speak
the same
way. We do. When I give in and let you know I understand you. What did you put on that, Catherine?
I didn't.
Lauren's watching.
Hi, Lauren. We miss you.
Oh, for goodness sakes, Cameron.
Try not to put it in the same place. Cammy. Come on, Cam. Well,
drool on his neck and on his nose where he was slobbering and slinging it a minute ago after getting grass in his mouth. He is a very picky eater. That's why he gets a couple of meals a day to try and get enough food into him. And he's 18 years old, which is a lot longer than they usually live.
Like, again, you probably have something in his mouth.
Yeah.
Maybe. Better than
Christine, I'm so glad that you were able to adapt our bloodsicles for your cat. People at home tell me that they like to use ice trays for that, so it makes a tiny little bloodsicle cat size for your cat. We use silo cups for the big cats. Feeding station if you won't go to it. Gets himself all worked up into a lather like that. That's what's on his nose and his neck. Jay, it's not cold, it's just wet and dark. We're glad you had a good time at the sanctuary. Thank you for coming and supporting the cats. And we really need the rain here. And I guess he's telling us that's it. We will see you guys tomorrow.
Did he kick you out? That's not very nice.